Hi, welcome to Barney Tech Channel. Here we are going to see about 95% stator earthfall production. In this 100% of winding, we are going to product only 95% of the winding by using this method. But normally on generator, to limit this phase 2 earthfall current, the current limiter was placed in between neutral to earth point. If you see the current limiter, it may be a neutral ground resistor or neutral ground transformer. Let us consider if the winding has a earth fault. During this earth fault current, it get limited due to this current limiter. Let us consider if the winding has earth fault. During this earth fault, the current is get limited due to high resistor or high impedance. Due to this current limiter, there will be a potential difference is created across the earth point to neutral. In this case, if there is no current limiter, then due to this fault, there will be a heavy current flowing. But on other hand, there will be a heavy voltage drop will be there. But we have a current limiter, so it reduces heavy current. But we have almost same potential of phase over the earth point. Now we all clear that how voltage is developed across this resistive path or high impedance path during the fault condition. Now, if you check the voltage across the neutral to ground point during the normal healthy condition, the potential difference will be zero. Now, we go for some case study. In all generator, the stator winding is covered completely with outer steel part known as yoke. In case 1, let us consider the 25% near to the phasor side winding, it has been touched with yoke accidentally. So, when we compare with the neutral side, the percentage will be 75%. In this case, if you want to know the voltage built across this high impedance, first we have to go for calculation. The earth fault is occurring at 75%. We are going to take a reference of generator voltage as 22 kV. Now we are going to calculate the voltage between earth point to neutral. First we have to find the single phase voltage, that is, we have to divide 22 kV by 1.732 and we have to multiply by the fault percentage, that is 0.75. We got 9.52 kV. The voltage across the high impedance, it will be 9.52 kV. Now we go for case 2. Let us consider at 50% of winding, it got earth fault. Now what will be the voltage value across here? As we did previous, we are going to do, but only we are going to change the percentage value. We got 6.3 kV. So when we check the voltage across this point, it will be 6.35 kV. Now we are going for one more case. Let us consider now at 5% of winding is got earth fault. Now what will be the voltage across here? Now we go for calculation. When we calculate, we got 0.635 kV. So when we check across this point, we will get 0.635 kV. For this 95% of fault, it is clear that the fault detect is start from the 5% of winding to 100% of winding. So it cover only 95% of the winding. Now we will see the SLD of generator. In this 95% of winding fault is got from NGT. Now I am going to elaborate this part alone. In generator, the neutral is connected with neutral grounding transformer, and from that neutral grounding transformer we have a VT connection, and the VT is connected to the relay for sensing fault, and this VT ratio is 220 kV bar 240 volt. Next we will see the reason for stator earth fault production. If the stator winding insulation get failed, we will get the earth fault. And also in any conductor get broken inside the turn to turn and it develop fault which may cause earth fault. Now we go for relay setting. For relay setting, I am going to take REG670 relay. In this stator earth fault function block, name is STEPHIZ. In this 95%, it has only two settings. One is UNFUND, that is voltage fundamental. Is setting value and we have to check its tripping time. Only these two we have to set for 95%. Now we will see how to test this 95% earth fault protection. Before going to testing, we have to see the NGT VT ratio. If you see it, it has 22 kV/240 V. So for relay testing, we have to inject and check the secondary voltage alone. The secondary voltage is 240 V. This voltage is achieved if it has only phase to phase earth fault. Now I am going to stimulate phase to earth fault. So I have to divide by 1.732, and the voltage which we got has to multiply by the set percentage. So here the set percentage is 5%. When we do all this calculation, we got 6.92 V on secondary. So I am going to inject 7 V, and relay has to give trip at 0.5 seconds. But if I inject 6.8, it should not trip. If I inject above value, it has to trip. By this, I believe that all will have a clear understanding on 95% of earth fault. On next section, I am planning to make 100% of earth fault. We came to the end of this section. See you on next video. If you like this section, then please share to your friends and colleagues. Take care and bye from Barney Tech channel. Thank you for watching this video.